Dr. Siema Iqbal. I am a GP partner and trainer of junior doctors in inner city Manchester. I've been a doctor for about 13 years. In fact, some of my medical students, where are they? They're in here in the crowd somewhere. Yes, I will sign you off on Friday, now you've turned up today. I'm standing here today not as a junior doctor, partly because I'm not junior by any stretch of the imagination. And these guys down here will do a fantastic job explaining the impact of Mr. Hunt's proposals on the profession. But I'm standing here today as a voice for my patients that I've looked after for the past 10 years. Let's be very clear. The driving force behind the changes to the contract is austerity, a desire to privatise the NHS. This is what it's all about. And it will affect my patients, so no, I'm not going to be silent. I'm going to fight to make sure my patients receive the best care possible. Care that they are entitled to. The free care they were promised when the NHS was created. For rich, for poor, man, woman or child. So no, I'm not going to let Mr. Hunt destroy the NHS by implementing changes that will inevitably lead to privatisation. I already witnessed the effects of austerity. I deal daily with the impact welfare cuts, NHS service cuts, unemployment and the housing crisis has on my patients. At times, I helplessly watch patients slide into depression or turn to alcohol or drugs as a result of financial worries, and then they lose their livelihoods and families. I know of parents who have missed meals to ensure their children can eat lunch in the school holidays. I know of patients who have no money to eat and no money for the transport to get to food banks. Patients with chronic mental health issues, who are the most vulnerable of society, are disproportionately being affected by the current austerity measures as they have their benefits cut and their care compromised due to mental health care cuts. And it's not just the students. I recently had a medical student with rising debt because of student fees, and she came in to ask me for part-time work at my practice because otherwise she would have had to choose between continuing her medical degree or working to earn a wage to help her family. These are the problems that need addressing. Mr. Hunt, don't frighten my patients by saying the services